Greetings, I'm Dr. Kim Kyo-won of Online Surgery. Today, let's look at a surgery using one CAS. First, let's take a look at the patient. 58-year-old male patient. The patient does not have any special systemic disease. The patient does have a little bit of a high blood pressure, however, there are no other symptoms. The patient has received implant in the past from a different dental clinic. If you look over here, in the upper right, number 16 and number 17 are missing. And it has been approximately 1 year since teeth were extracted. The patient came in for implant treatment. If you look at the CT in number 16, there's sufficient amount of residual alveolar bone, approximately 10 millimeter. As I designed one guide, I noticed that there was possibility of sinus penetration. I decided to use one CAS drill to place the implant. In number 16, there's sufficient amount of residual alveolar bone, about 10 millimeters. In number 17 on CT, the residual alveolar bone, it doesn't look sufficient on the panoramic image. However, if you look at the palatal side, there's quite a lot of residual bone. On the buccal side, it's resorbed. However, in the palatal side, there's sufficient bone. Therefore, if you place it here, you don't need to touch upon the sinus on CT or on panoramic image. On the sinus, there's mucosal thickening and mucoseal. Mucosal retention cyst may exist. We can proceed as is. In the past, as the teeth were taken out, bone graft was done. I believe xenograft was used at the time because alveolar bone was not in a good condition. I think the previous dentist did socket preservation and used bone graft. And you can see that on CT. The patient was not really aware of this. However, if you look at it, you can see that there has been bone graft in the past. In the surgical report, number 16 and 17, one CAS was decided to be used. In the surgical report, TS3 was recommended. However, I decided to use KS3 implant. In number 16, residual alveolar bone is 10 millimeters and is sufficient. In number 16, I'm guessing the bone will be slightly soft, like D2 to D3. KS3 5.0 by 10 millimeter implant was planned in number 17. The one guy, the team anticipated that there may be a need for bone graft due to slight penetration of the sinus because the residual alveolar bone was insufficient. However, I believe if we reduce the length to 8.5, we wouldn't need any bone graft within the sinus. As mentioned earlier, in the past, there was socket preservation and bone graft was done. Bone graft material can be seen in the posterior area. The bone seems to be harder because xenograft was used. In order to prepare for sinus floor penetration, one CAS drill was determined to be used for the surgery. In the posterior area, I decided to on 8.5 to avoid sinus bone graft. KS3 implant in number 16, 5.0 by 10 millimeter implant was planned. The drill sequence was as shown. This was one CAS drill. If you have used one guide, you know, but in the case of one CAS, unlike a CAS drill, which is for the freehand, you need to use stopper, so this can be confusing. Therefore, I'm going to provide explanation on this point. The residual alveolar bone is 10 millimeter, And therefore, 2.2 by 7 millimeter initial drill is going to be done. And I'm going to increase by 1 millimeter. For the 10 millimeter drill, I'm going to use 2 millimeter stopper. So 8 millimeter drilling is going to be done. And then I'm going to use 1 millimeter stopper so that 9 millimeter drilling is done. The depth gauge, the stopper is 1 millimeter. It becomes a 0.6 millimeter longer, and you need to check whether it's not penetrated. Then 2.2 by 10. When you use one Gehess drill, you need to use the double contact concept of the drill, and therefore you need to use 7 millimeter first. If the residual alveolar bone is over 8 millimeter, you need to use 7 millimeter drill first. When you go in, the guide on the drill, it hits the barrel and the drill goes in more stably, and after that, you can use drill consecutively from then on. You need to use the double contact concept for drilling in order to improve stability, and as shown, you need to use 2.8 and 3.8 by 7 millimeter drilling. After that, you can use the final drill 3.8 by 10 millimeter. With depth gauge, check whether the sinus floor is penetrated and then place the implant. In the case of number 17, KS3 5.0 by 8.5 was planned. In the one-guided design, if I use a 10 millimeter implant, then it will penetrate the sinus floor and bone graft may be needed. However, the current residual alveolar bone is approximately 9 millimeter, and therefore, if you use 8.5, I believed that it would not penetrate. As shown, after tissue punch, considering the residual alveolar bone height, I used a 7 millimeter drill with 2 millimeter stopper, and then I increased it to 3.8. 3.8 by 7 millimeter drill was used with 1 millimeter stopper, and therefore it is 6 millimeter. The depth gauge is 10 millimeter, and after 6 millimeter drilling, you need to add 4 millimeter stopper to make it 6 millimeter. That's how it's done. After that, 3.8 by 10 millimeter drill and 3 millimeter stopper was used. In other words, 7 millimeter drilling was done, 3.8 by 10 millimeter drill with 2 millimeter stopper. So drilling was done up until 8 millimeter. Up until then, there was no penetration. And then I used a 3.8 by 10 millimeter with 1 millimeter stopper. In other words, 9 millimeter drilling. It was not fully penetrated then. So without additional bone graft, 8.5 millimeter KS3 implant was used. I'm showing you this case because although hydrolift was not done, this was implant placement using one guide, and it was upper posterior and one cast drill was used, and therefore I believed it would be useful for you. If you pay attention to how stopper is used in one cast drill sequence, I believe it will be of great help to you when you use one guide system and one cast drill. As shown here, this is what we planned. 5.0 by 10 millimeter and 8.5 millimeter implants were planned. And after surgery, you can see that implants were placed in the planned area. If you look at the CT in number 16, the residual alveolar bone was 10 millimeter, and you can see that implant was placed nicely. In the case of number 17, sinus floor is slightly engaged. It is not fully penetrated on CT, as shown here, number 16 and 17. Sinus floor is slightly, barely penetrated here. And without bone graft, using one cast in the desired area, implant was placed, healing abutment was connected, and surgery was completed. In the surgical video, I hope you understand and focus on the drill sequence and stopper. I believe it will be of great help to you. Please enjoy the video clip. One guide template is adapted. Attached gingiva was sufficient in this case, and flapless surgery was done. Tissue punch was done to punch the gingiva. Tissue punch was used. after that, you can see that gingiva may not be removed thoroughly. Template was removed and tissue is removed. And after that, subsequent drilling is going to be done. Initial drill, 2.2 by 7 millimeter twisted drill was used. Even if the residual alveolar bone is more than 7 millimeter. For initial drill, you need to use 7 millimeter drill. Check with depth gauge, even though I'm pretty sure it's not penetrated. On one cusp 10 millimeter, 2 millimeter stopper has been connected, 8 millimeter drilling is being done, and after that, 1 millimeter stopper is connected, and drilling is done up to 9 millimeter. After that, depth gauge, 1 millimeter stopper is connected to check whether there is penetration. I'm going to drill up to 10 millimeter, so I'm not going to use a stopper this time. Depth gauge is used to check for penetration once again. After that, 2.8 by 7 millimeter is used for drilling. Even if the residual bone is over 7 millimeter, you need to start with 7 millimeter in order to have the double contact concept. 3.8 by 7 millimeter drilling is done. Although residual bone is sufficient, 2.8 by 7 millimeter drill with 2 millimeter stopper is used for drilling up to 5 millimeter. Next, 3.8 by 7 millimeter and 2 millimeter stopper is used, and 1 millimeter stopper is used. Drilling is done up to 6 millimeter. 4 millimeter stopper is connected and depth gauge is used for checking. 3.8 by 10 millimeter drill and 3 millimeter stopper is connected, so drilling up to 7 millimeter is done. Next, depth gauge with 3 millimeter stopper is used to check for penetration. Next, a 10 millimeter drill with 2 millimeter stopper, so drilling up to 8 millimeter. Depth gauge without stopper is used to check. Next, I'm going to use 1 millimeter stopper and drilling is done up to 9 millimeter. There's partial penetration. However, this is not a huge issue. So without bone graft, the 5.0 by 8.5 implant is being placed.
Okay.
Healing above my legs connected and surgery is now complete. On panoramic image, the residual bone height did not seem enough. However, there was sufficient bone on the palatal side, and with altered path, I was able to place the implant. Although no hydrolift was done, one cast kit was used. And you can see how one cast kit is used in sequence using digital guide. Compared with cast drill, one cast is a little bit more complicated because of stoppers, so please take note of the drill sequence. Thank you for watching.